It was weird last year, too. I did 4 shows in 3 prisons as a comic, not as a stripper. And I mention that because they totally wish I was a stripper. Maybe not me as a stripper, but literally any, maybe me as a stripper, some of them me as a stripper, literally any stripper. And I would argue you would not have to be that great of a stripper to just crush it in the prison system. In fact, that's like a nice retirement program, right? Like, look, Cinnamon, you're getting a little long in the tooth to shake your biscuits at the Cha-Cha-Cha Club. How would you like to show your G-string to a guy that stabbed a Cub Scout because he was confused about which uniformed children sell the cookies? You get a G-string full of ramen noodles at $200 cash. You need to know about ramen noodles in prison, sir. I don't know if you know this or not, but in prison you used to be able to smoke, but you can't smoke anymore. So now it's a ramen noodle-based economy. And that's important information, because when you guys end up doing stand-up comedy in a prison, and I'm sure you will, you're gonna be have to be careful about what you talk to them about, because some of the people in prison, as you well know, are sex offenders, and you don't want to point that out, because it's not that I'm worried about offending the sex offenders, it's when the other prisoners remember that that guy's a sex offender, they tend to beat the living crap out of them, right? And since it's a Christmas party, and they're already in prison, I figure let's just try to get through the night without a vent, shall we? So I'm in minimum security prison, and I go, hey man, what's your name? How do you make your ramen noodles? And one guy goes, my name's Fred. I break the brick in half and put peanut butter in between the layers. It's delicious. Well, that's great. Another guy goes, I partially boil the noodles. I make a bowl, and then I put chili in the bowl, and I put cheese and onions on that. I'm like, wow, that's amazing. They give you cans of chili in prison? And he goes, no. They give us bags of chili in prison, and I go, oh, so it's a meal, and it's a girlfriend, and we laughed. And then I went to maximum security prison, and when you get to maximum security prison in Bismarck, there's a 30-foot wall. I'm serious. 2 shows maximum, 30-foot wall on the outside covered in barbed wire, but I grew up in the 80s, so when I see that much barbed wire, I'm like, Ozzy, you know what I mean? And you have to go through all these heavy doors that lock behind you, right, that chook when you get in, so if you want to leave, it's going to be a hassle, right? Like, if you jump the stage, I go that way, I go that way, I have options. Not in prison. If you want to get out, it's going to be a problem, right? But in that way, it's kind of like working a cruise ship, you know what I mean? And also, the shrimp cocktail, fantastic. So, I'm in maximum security prison, and the guy, the guard and I are like chewing the fat, and he's trying to psych me up for the show, and he goes, just so you know, and by the way, when you perform in the prison I perform in, they don't lower you in a protective cage. They just put you in the middle of a basketball court where the closest prisoner's like is you from me. No, you from me. Like, that's how far the felons are from this delicious body. Do you see why that's horrifying? So this guy's trying to psych me up, and he's like, just so you know, these guys are trying to figure out if they can kick your butt. Now, I would argue that's a terrible pep talk under any circumstances, but especially when you're throwing me into a basketball court full of felons, you jackass. But like, even if it was like, look, you're the best ballerinas in the tri-state area, but if you don't crush this rendition of the Nutcracker, these Shriners and senior citizens are gonna rip the meat off your bones. You need to know that. So I go out, and the PA system is terrible. They can't hear me, and comedy is about hearing you, right? So for them, the show is like, hey, and they're getting mad, right? And they're felons. So I'm like, well, let's do the ramen noodle stuff. So I'm like, hey, man, what's your name? How do you make your ramen noodles? And this guy goes, my name's Chrome. Say something funny. And I'm trying to make this joke as family-friendly as possible, so I'm going to paraphrase just slightly. Say something funny, one who makes love to people's mothers. So I go, well, I hear something funny. When I get done with this show, I get to walk out that door. It gets worse. And then I am gonna make love to your mother. He did not take kindly to that. He shoots a up out of his chair and he said, "What'd you say about my mother?" Here's the thing. I've done comedy for a long time, you guys. I did comedy in Dickinson, North Dakota during the oil rush, where the ratio of penises to vaginas is exactly the same as it is in maximum security prison. I've seen a lot of your mamas fly back and forth. I have never seen anyone take it literally, okay? I've never seen anyone be like, "I will not sit here and listen to you badmouth Elizabeth Mickelson in front of this room full of felons. Not today, sir." So I am told, I go like this. This is like a fighting pose that I get. There's nothing behind that, sir. There's nothing there. Look, I have not, like, I had a yellow belt in fourth grade. And since then, I have not so much as watched a YouTube tutorial about how to throw a punch. Okay, there's nothing here. But this guy is hiding behind, okay, they're in folding chairs, and they're lighter than these. That's heavier. These folding chairs are like wrestling, like, you know how in professional wrestling, the chairs that hit each other with, that's what they're sitting on. And he's two rows in, two from the aisle, and he's flummoxed. He's like, "If I get around this maze of folding, Joe, you're dead, but I gotta get out of this first, and I don't know how that's gonna work. I should have brought a Sherpa or something, because this is crazy." And the guards finally drag him away, and I'm like, "Whew, I'm glad he was bluffing, you know? He was playing, let's see if we can make the comedian poop in front of the felons." And I'm fine with that, because if he wasn't, they would have written one of those stories about me, right? He died doing what he loves. Which is not true. I do not love getting kicked in the neck by a felon. I love watching Netflix with my wife.